Hey yo, how's it going guys? ZHouse today, back with a brand new video. And today I want to talk a little bit about the new Galaxy Books that Samsung has released at their Galaxy Unpacked 2021. So 2 weeks prior to the event, they released a trailer on YouTube announcing their live stream and the date of it. And I gotta tell you, it was of Hollywood quality. But whether or not the actual live stream and the actual laptops hold up to these expectations, we're about to see. At the Galaxy Unpacked event, they unveiled 4 different Windows 10 laptops, each for a different person. We'll start off with the flashiest laptop, the Galaxy Book Pro. This is a model that probably most people will go for. It's a very portable laptop, with the 30.3-inch model weighing under a kilogram. Even the 15.6-inch model, which is barely over that 1 kilogram mark. Both are very thin. A big part of the appeal of these laptops are their AMOLED displays. If you don't know about Samsung, well, Samsung makes a lot of great displays, especially in their smartphones. They do not only make industry-leading revolutionary displays that they use in their smartphones, but which also sell to ironically their own competitors like Apple. So Samsung makes one of the best AMOLED displays in the industry, and we will get the opportunity to see whether or not they have the ability to implement this in their laptops as well. Both the 13.3-inch model and the 15.6-inch model have unfortunately 1920 by 1080 pixel resolution. Now this might save on battery life and might not even be in 1920p display. A 1080p display might not even be that much different to an average user, but to the professional user who wants to use this for professional work, this might be a deal breaker. However, they do make work for that with their certifications. So they both carry Display HDR 500 certifications, meaning that they have a wide color gamut and a brightness up to 500 nits. They have a 120% coverage of the DC IP3 color gamut and a fast 0.2ms response time. You could also toggle sRGB and Adobe RGB modes depending on your task. Both laptops are powered by 11th gen Intel Core processors. You could choose among an i3 and i5 and an i7 with RAM configurations varying with 8, 16 and 32 gigs of LPDDR4X RAM. Storage comes in the form of an NVMe SSD up to 1 TB of storage. Might not be the most storage you can get, but it should be fast enough to satisfy your needs. Unfortunately, it seems like the i3 model will come with Intel integrated graphics instead of Intel's new Xe graphics, which are leagues ahead their old graphics. However, there is an optional GeForce MX450 GPU, but it adds weight, thickness, and possibly it would drain the battery life much more if you select that option instead of the integrated graphics. There are multiple performance modes, a silent mode, even a no fan mode. This might be helpful for people who want to be productive on their laptop, but who really hate their machine making any noise. Port selection is quite decent. We have a micro SD card slot, USB, a Type-A USB 3.2, a mic port, a headphone or microphone, a 3.5mm headphone or microphone jack, an HDMI port, a USB Type-C port, a USB Type-C with Thunderbolt 4. I should mention that a 13.3-inch model does not come with an HDMI port, but it does make up for that with a nano SIM card slot. This might be a deal breaker for those people who do not like to carry around dongles with them and who always like to be connected on the go. Unfortunately, the new 5G only has 4G LTE connectivity, and it turns out the 15.6-inch model is Wi-Fi 6E ready, which should be plentiful enough, which should be really, really fast for your, for all your gaming needs, whatever you use a network for. We also have EKG tuned audio with Dolby Atmos support and a 720p webcam and a fingerprint reader and a power key. However, I should mention that I just finished watching this laptop's review on Short Circuit. Alex apparently reviews, Alex did review this laptop. And although it was an engineering sample, two major flaws that I found was the fact that the speakers were not as good as other Windows laptops. And even though it has so-called EKG tuned audio, it's just marketing at this point. And secondly, again, this is an engineering sample, and this might be different. And the laptop that actual end users receive might be different. But it turns out if you touch the bottom of the laptop, you actually touch the trackpad. Like you touch the buttons on the trackpad. Like, take a moment to realize what I'm saying. When you hold the laptop, it's like you're pressing buttons on the trackpad. I mean, come on, Samsung, come on. Seriously, trivial mistakes like that? But we'll see. The 13.3 inch Galaxy Book Pro weighs about 0.7 kilograms, or 0.88 kilograms if you want LTE. And it only measures 11.2 millimeters thick and comes with a 63 watt hour battery. The 15.6 inch model, on the other hand, weighs 1.05 kilograms and is 11.7 millimeters thick. It also has a slightly larger 68 watt hour battery. In both cases, the laptops are charged over USB-C with a small 65 watt adapter, so it should charge quite fast, or fast enough. Pre-orders already has already started, and sales will begin on May 14th. Pre-orders are already started and sales begin on May 14th. In the US, the Galaxy Book Pro starts at $1,000 for the 13.3 inch Galaxy Book Pro and $1,100 for the 15.6 inch Galaxy Book Pro. They are all obviously different pricing, different countries. It seems that Europe's are paying slightly higher prices for these models. But yeah, I guess that's it. And secondly, the second laptop that was released at Galaxy Unpacked 2021 is the Galaxy Book Pro 360. And if you're wondering what this Galaxy laptop is about, well, there's everything in the name. It's basically a Galaxy Book Pro with 360 degrees angle swiveling. You can turn the laptop around 360 degrees, making it into a tablet, and it also has S Pen support for students who want to take notes, for artists who want to draw, who want to use Photoshop, basically everything that you might need to use with S Pen. Tech specs wise, it's basically the same. It has basically the same specs as the Galaxy Book Pro, apart from being a 2-in-1 laptop and having S Pen support. I should mention that the 13.3 inch Galaxy Book Pro 360 offers optional 5G connectivity, and that's an upgrade over the 4G connectivity of the Galaxy Book Pro, the normal version. But the 15.6 inch Galaxy Book Pro 360 also misses out on 4G, on 4G or 5G connectivity. Both models of the Galaxy Book Pro 360 of Wi-Fi 6E ready. For wired connections, you do get a Thunderbolt 4 port, two USB Type-C ports, a 3.5 mm headphone microphone jack, and a micro SD card slot. These 5G laptops also have a nano SIM card slot. Like the Pros, these are powered by Intel i3, i7, Intel i3, i5, and i7, i5, and only i5 and i7 options have Intel Xe graphics. But unfortunately, there's no option for an NVIDIA MX 450 now with the Galaxy Book Pro 360. Storage goes up to 1 TB, batteries are the same, Gain module. I should also mention that both the Galaxy Book, both Galaxy Book Pro models are something MIL-STD-810G rated with tests for low and high pressure, vibration, dust humidity, and even salt spray. Also, these two laptops are part of the Intel Evo programming mark of quality that also includes features like instant wake, best-in-class connectivity, and a long battery life. Basically, these are really good laptops with good quality. The Galaxy Book Pro 360 would be a little bit more expensive than the Galaxy Book Pro, starting at $1,200 for the 13.3-inch model and $1,300 for the 15.6-inch model, slightly higher pricing than the Galaxy Book Pro, but I would definitely recommend it for artists or students who are thinking about getting both a laptop and a tablet, as this option would be much cheaper and much more convenient for use, in my opinion. But if you're only looking for a laptop, definitely go for the Galaxy Book Pro. Again, Europe models with Europe countries will have to pay slightly higher pricing for these models. And finally, we get to talk about the Galaxy Book Pro Odyssey. This is the beast of the beast, the best of the best. This is a beast. It has everything you might expect in a laptop. This is a laptop you would select if you prefer performance over portability. But I should mention, it seems quite portable compared to other performance laptops. Again, still easy, fairly easy to carry around. It only has a 15.6-inch model, weighing at 1.85 kilograms, and measures only 17.7 millimeters thick. And this bigger size is compensated by the larger 83 watt-hour battery. And if you select the Galaxy Book Odyssey, you also get a beefier charger at 135 watts, again through Type-C. This time, you get to choose instead of Xe graphics, on top of Xe graphics, I should say, you get to choose between a default RTX 3050 Ti Max-Q or a vanilla 3050 Max-Q. So I think this would depend on you in terms of pricing and what kind of battery life you expect from your device. Unfortunately, we do not have an i3 model for this time. I would not expect someone to rock a 3050 Ti with an i3. You could get this laptop from the store with either 8, 16 or 32 gigs of LPDDR4X RAM and an NVMe SSD up to 1 TB. But since this is not a compact model, since it is a practical model, you could put in your own RAM and a second NVMe slot for more storage. And this will provide you with more storage options and cheaper RAM, because oftentimes you will see when companies offer you for upgrades on the laptops, it will be much more expensive than third-party ones. Connectivity is also great, as far as ports go. You get two USB Type-C ports, three USB Type-A 3.2 ports, an HDMI and HDMI port, a headphone microphone jack, a micro SD card slot, a security slot, and even a storage slot. I don't really know what this means, but yeah, it is there if you need it. And even an RJ45 if you want to hook into LAN. This would be really great connectivity for gamers who want loaded intense gaming. As we all know, Wi-Fi has a lot of latency, but if you connect over a wired connection, over RJ45, over Ethernet for example, RJ45 or Ethernet, latency decreases significantly, and you also have a better, a faster and a more stable connection. Unfortunately, you do not get neither an E4G or 5G option here, but you do get a Wi-Fi 6 laptop, which is plenty full enough. However, this time we do not have a display that is as accurate as the Galaxy Book Pro models. The Galaxy Book Pro Odyssey has a 15.6 inch TFT LCD with a 1920x1080p resolution. Unfortunately, a downgrade from the Galaxy Book Pro, so we get worse colors, and on top of that, they haven't even increased the pixel count. But again, this might not be a deal breaker to the average consumer, who might not even notice it on that small of a display. Unfortunately, I do not seem to have any pricing info on the Galaxy Book Pro Odyssey. In my opinion, it should be priced much higher than this $1,300 mark of the Galaxy Book Pro. But you might ask, Zeta, what if I'm just a student? I'm just a broke student. I'm just broke in general. What if I need something much more cheaper, much more basic? I do not need all those fancy features. But I still want to get into the Samsung ecosystem. I still want to get a Samsung product because I have faith in them. Well, the Samsung Galaxy Book might be a great option for you. This is a basic model of the series, but it is quite capable. If you don't need RTX GPU and do not want to pay for an AMOLED display, this vanilla laptop is the one to look at. It has a 15.6 inch TFT LCD and an 11th gen Intel Core, either i3, i5 or i7. There will be more affordable versions with a Pentium Gold and even Celeron processor too. There's also a Galaxy Book laptop with an enorm version of the Galaxy Book laptop, more on that later. In terms of availability of ports, we get a micro SD card slot, a 3.5mm microphone jack, headphone jack, a Type A USB 3.2 slot, USB 2 port, security slot, Type C slot, Type C port, HDMI port, Type A 3.2 port, and another Type C. Doesn't seem on. We have Thunderbolt support on this one. RAM starts at 14GB with 18 and 16GB available. You also can get a single NVMe SSD up to 512GB, but you could add a second SSD. You also fortunately have the option to get a GeForce MX 450 GPU, a discrete laptop graphics card if that's what you want. This model is still reasonably thin and light, measuring 15.4mm and 1.5kg, still more thicker and heavier than the Pro models, which has, in my opinion, beefier specs. You get a lower 54 watt hour battery, which charges over USB-C at 65 watts. The audio setup misses out on EKG's touch, but you still get Dolby Atmos. The fingerprint reader and the power button is optional. Again, just to save money. Unlike the Odyssey, however, this does have LTE to go along with Wi-Fi 6. The port selection is great. I've always talked about the port selection. This model would still be start at £700 in the UK for an i5 and 8GB of RAM, and in Germany this will be available from May 14th at €680 for a Core i3 processor, 8GB of RAM and 256GB of storage. Listen, also after reviewing the Galaxy Book base model, I don't think that I would recommend this to anyone, especially students. This is a very expensive laptop. At this price point, you might even choose to go with Lenovo's Yoga Book series, which has a better processor, more storage, more RAM, same basic display, same basic 1080p display. Panzerport, basically, you could get, if you could get four better at this price point. I think Samsung's basically ripping you off with the Samsung Galaxy Book, with the Samsung Galaxy Book series. So this did not get announced at, at the Galaxy Unpacked event. But it turns out, one day after, we get news of a Galaxy Book Go. So if you're even more broke, unfortunately, and if you need a laptop which is, well, cheaper than these models, than the previous models, we have the Galaxy Book Go. This is a 1449 euros Windows 10 laptop with an ARM processor. Something laptop news just keep arriving after announcing four laptops yesterday and everyone blah blah blah. So yeah, this is quite kind of get disappointing. When I originally saw the launch event, I was expecting Samsung to have created their own Exynos processors to go with their laptops, just as Apple has done with their M1 chips, which was amazing. This time it really works just like magic. Its performance is incredible. I don't think any laptop to this day matches with the performance of the M1. No laptop matches with the performance of the M1, at least in terms of processing power. The Galaxy Book Pro, Book Go model does not have an Exynos processor. We've seen Exynos processor failing terribly in the past 2 years. We've even have the Galaxy S20 with the worst Exynos processor, with the Exynos 990. The thing is terrible. Firmware throttles all the time in summer. And this Galaxy Book Go runs on an 8-nanometer Qualcomm Snapdragon 7C chip and the ARM version of Windows 10. So quite disappointing, no Exynos processor, no Exynos magic. The machine is fanless, has a 14-inch 1920x1080p IPS LCD, built-in LTE, 4GB of RAM, and a 128GB SSD. It's basically like a Chromebook. Unfortunately, the screen isn't touch-enabled, the housing is field standard, again, just to keep costs low. However, it does comply with the MIL 810G durability standards, meaning the laptop can withstand a drop of 1.2 meters and is dust tight. Laptop weighs 1.39 kilograms. There are two USB-C ports, one of the USB variety, a headphone jack, a microSD card slot, and a SIM slot. So you do get 4G connectivity on this one. ARM-based processors are usually very efficient, which is in tandem, which is in compliance with the smaller 42.3 watt-hour battery and should provide ample battery life. However, as I've stated before, Windows 10's ARM version has a poor selection of native apps and a not-so-good track record of emulating x64 apps. As a matter of fact, the M1-based ARM Max emulate x64 apps 1,000 times better than Windows 10 ARM laptops themselves. Windows 10 on ARM is very much a work in progress and nowhere near the refined thing that the ARM-based M1 Max are. The Galaxy Book Go isn't out yet. There's no official availability information from Samsung itself. However, the laptop will launch in Germany, priced at 449 euros, and US will be cheaper, $349, but without LTE. It's quite a bummer. So yeah, as I've stated previously in the intro, the launch event and the Galaxy Book laptops, in my opinion, does not quite match up to expectation. Sure, they have an AMOLED display. Sure, they might be great laptops. Pricing horrible. display, how could they miss out on having a much more detailed a display with higher resolution? Speak, they have terrible speakers and they flex quite a lot. Build quality is not great on the Galaxy Book Pro. When watching the trailer for the launch event, I was expecting something much more performance, something much more unique than just throwing in an Intel i7. An Intel i7 in there, I was expecting Samsung to finally get their things together and, actually create an Exynos processor that matters, that can perform better than Intel's processors, but Windows on ARM is probably a thing that's reserved for the future. So yeah, it was quite disappointing to me, honestly, even though with all these great features, I'll give it to you, they did a lot of great things, but they did also miss out on a lot of things. There's a lot of better and cheaper alternatives you could get out there. Anyways, this has been ZetaHost. I hope I've been able to inform you on these five laptops released by Samsung in the past couple of days. This has been ZetaHost. I really hope you've enjoyed this video. If you could, please like and subscribe to my channel. It costs nothing and you could always unsubscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one.